Hi guys, so today I'm going to show you how to make these wonderful eggs. And I know it's not Easter here in the United States, but it is Easter today on Sunday in Russia, and by the Russian church it is Easter today. And on Easter we would make eggs, well, we would hard boil them, we would color them and make different applications in them. This sort of eggs are made with just shell from the onions with some pieces. I will show you step by step how to make these. It's really easy to make, really. They didn't turn out all the way I would want it to be, but it's still, they still look pretty nice. If you pay attention, you can see that this is not painted on the egg. It's the actual imprint of the leaf, and this is where the, I tighten it up with the pantyhose. If you're interested in seeing how I made this, you're welcome to stay tuned and I will show you step by step. Thank you. Okay, so I just shelled a couple of the onions already, but basically I just need loose skin from the onion. Doesn't have to be pretty, doesn't mean, it doesn't matter what color it is. Well, it is preferably to have dark or yellow onions, not white. And what I will do, I will just color the eggs naturally. Loud. And I'm doing it with one hand. And this is some of the things do on our Easter. You can go to the market and this one's not coming off. You can go to the market and just hand pick the onions and maybe take some of the shell with you from the ones close to them, just additionally. Doesn't come off anymore. Taking it off. It should come off easily. I'm only using one hand, so it's a little bit hard for me. But we'll get it. Okay. I know that this is probably really loud. So now, onions can still be used, but we need as much of this shell as we can get. Just press down on it, sort of to keep it down. this right now. Okay, so the next step will be wrapping the eggs into pantyhose. As funny as it might sound, you can just find a clean pair of cheap pantyhose or the ones that you got ripped or something, and just make cutouts just like this out of them. Then we'll take an egg, any size too, but it has to be white, so it's gonna get colored. Then you would take different pieces, whatever you want really. I sometimes use dill, but I don't have dill right now, or cilantro or something, so I will be using, I don't have any herbs right now unfortunately, but I will be using this flower with this leaves, and I will be using this piece. I keep forgetting what's the name of it. So basically what you need to do is open up this part. The egg, you would put your application the way you would want it to be. So for example, in my case, I would put it like this. Then I would take the pantyhose and I would carefully hold it in place. Like so. You can adjust it to whichever way you want it. And then you just tighten it up as much as you can to press on the part that's not going to be completely straight. Like this. And then here, in the end, on the other side, you would make a knot out of the rest. Just carefully making a knot, making sure that it's closed down. Very good. Now I'll take my scissors and I will cut off the excess. Just like that. So this is it. Take another egg, and now we'll do an application with leaves and the flower. So we'll take a flower. I would need to try and put it flat against the egg, so it's gonna print well. Then I would take this leaf. Right next to it, also pressing flat. Now I'm taking my pantyhose and trying to be quick and careful. There is it. And now I'm going to pull hard on it to press it as tight as possible to the egg. So right now it looks really funny, but it will imprint perfectly. And we twist the end again and we make a knot. There are a lot of different variations of doing eggs like this. You can press really anything, any shape, as long as it's gonna get really close and tight to the egg. And we're cutting off the excess of the hose. So this is our second egg. I'm gonna do another one with the leaf there. So again, we'll take the egg. Sorry for any extra sound. You would put this Let me do it the other way around now. Put this flat against the egg. Pressing. Very good. You see? And now, I'm going to put it through the pantyhose. Very good. And we will tighten it up. Closer, as close as possible to the egg. Yeah, I won't be able to adjust it right now, but it's okay. Still gonna look wonderful. And I'm gonna knot it again. Pulling it tight. There you go. And we're going to cut off the axis one more time. Mm-hmm. Really good. Do you want to do another one? Let's do one more with the flower. We'll take another white egg. We'll take another flower. Press it. Close. Egg. Don't break the egg though. Like this. Mm-hmm. And then, let me see, I'll try to do it this way. I'll try to put it close, like so. And now we'll put it through our pantyhose. That's gonna be tricky. Yeah, the leaf fell off. Yeah, this one's not gonna work out. So what we'll do, I'll just show you the color of this one. If you just boil it in the shell. So, and these are fresh. Yeah? They are not boiled yet. So now we're going to put our eggs into this mixture. Another white egg, so we'll have two regular white eggs in just this color. Then we'll take our banded ones with the imprints, put it down, take another one, put this one down as well, face down. Well, it doesn't really matter, just preferably face down. And again, another one. Okay. And we're gonna pour water on top of them. The eggs have to be completely covered under water. Salt. Sorry, I had to reach for it. I'm sorry. Okay. I didn't plan for that. We need to salt it so they won't break. Okay. And now we're gonna take the cover and we'll put it on the medium. I'm gonna put it on the high for now. Once it starts boiling, I will lower it down to a medium or about 6 or 5. And we'll keep it boiling for about 10 minutes or so. Well, maybe a little bit, slightly more. We'll see by the color of the white eggs if the color has penetrated it fully. So we'll be able to tell about it then. For now, we just rest and wait. Okay, so now it's been about 12 minutes or so, and you can see that the color of the egg changing. That's the completely white one. It's becoming more of a brown color. And the ones in the pantyhose also changing color, which is really good. Because the more we boil it for, the sharper the image of the imprint will be. So you can already see it's darker brown of the egg. I will let it boil for a couple more minutes just to make sure that it's going to be nice and covered up in this brownish kind of a color. And then I'll see you back again. Okay, so after they boiled for about 15 minutes or so, this is what you come up with. This is a boiled egg. It's a hard boiled egg. And it has this brown color. I already wiped these off. These two. So this is just what it turns out to be after you just boil them in the eggshell. Oh, I'm sorry, in the onion shell. And now we're gonna undo the wrapped ones. I'll just cut them open. Sorry for any extra sounds again. And once we take it off, this is what you get in the end. And let me just take my paper towel. And I will just wipe it off slightly. So now you can see how pretty this is, isn't it? It's just amazing. And I will undo all of them and I'm going to put a layer of oil on top of it. Okay. This is the one with the flour. I'm going to wipe it off again. This is what this one turned out to look like. I think it's still pretty nice look. Pretty awesome look. And the last one, same thing. I know this has got to be not too relaxing, but I was just doing these eggs because it's Easter today in Russian calendar, Russian church calendar. And I just thought I'll make these and show you too. And this is the third one. So now, I just dipped a paper towel into oil. Now we'll just spread it around over the egg to keep the color glistening. Now I'll just put it down to dry out a little bit. Now it's the same as all of them. Looks very good. Once the oil penetrated, well, it's sort of absorbed by the eggshell, it will look the egg look. It will make the egg look really nice and shiny and pretty. But you probably will see the better picture in the very beginning of it. I'll edit it up so you can see it better. So I would like to wish good Easter to my Russian viewers. Христос воскресе! Я поздравляю вас с Пасхой. Желаю удачи, счастья и всего самого хорошего. Спасибо большое за внимание. Okay, guys.